Good evening, everyone. And thank you all for joining us for this Q&A with Jackson State University President Thomas Hudson. I am Anaiah Evans, a senior communicative disorders major from Memphis, Tennessee. I'd first like to begin by thanking all of my fellow students for the questions you have submitted for tonight's discussion. As one of your student leaders, it is very important for me to represent your concerns and ask the necessary questions to keep us informed. Secondly, I want to thank President Hudson and his team for actually organizing this Q&A. This is something that he wanted to do to hear from us and to address our concerns. And now we will start to answer some of our student questions. So President Hudson, can you please explain your role and responsibility during these challenging times as the president of this great university?
Well, Anaiah, these are indeed challenging times for Jackson State University and really universities across the Southeast. And I describe my role as being one of accountability, transparency, and also performance. It is important that as president, I am accountable for each and everything that happens on this campus, even those things that we can't necessarily control or predict. It is also important that I be transparent and communicate exactly what's going on to the student body so they can make the most informed decisions. I did not have the option of holding back information as it related to the water crisis. I had to let you know that we did not have a definite time frame for when the water would be turned back on and let you make the most informed decision that you could. Finally, and this is most important to you, is performance. I do not have the option of waiting on the city or waiting on any other entity to take care of our students. We had to do what we needed to provide clean drinking water for you all, provide hot showers, portable toilets, and also make sure you had the proper food and water to continue with your daily activities. So again, it's up to me to make sure that the university gets through these times, as I'm responsible for each and every student here.
Thank you so much, President Hudson, for that answer. Now for our next question. President Hudson, could you please elaborate on the Jackson State University plan for bathing and showering for students?
Well, as stated, we do not have a specific time frame for when the water pressure will be back up. So right now we are providing portable showers for our students. Those will be placed outside the residence halls. They will be secured, they will be sanitized daily, and we're providing those for the comfort of our students. We also have porta-johns, portable restrooms, for our students to utilize while during this time, this crisis. And of course, we are providing drinking water and portable water for toiletries.
Okay, on to our next question. So some students and I were inquiring about, will there be a plan of action in the event that this situation happens again?
Well, absolutely. One of the things we've learned, first of all, is that you can never be over-prepared. So certainly we want to make sure that we have plenty of clean water available for us just in case such a situation arises. Also, we're looking at alternate water sources. When I look at entities such as UMMC, the Jackson Medical Mall, they were able to keep functioning because they had an alternate water supply. We'll be looking into that for Jackson State University in the future. We definitely want to be in a position where such a thing happens again, and it will, we're properly prepared to keep running the campus.
Okay, so President Hudson, is there a safety cleaning protocol for the bathrooms and the showers or the porta-johns or the porta-potties?
Absolutely. We have an external vendor that's actually providing those for us, and they're responsible for cleaning it on a daily basis, cleaning and sanitizing. In addition, we'll be providing disinfectant and all the materials to the students so they can do it themselves, so that just adds an extra layer of protection as well.
Yes, sir. So President Hudson, recently students were encouraged to return home. And so some students were inquiring about, will they be receiving a housing refund or a meal plan refund in the instance that they decide to return home?
Well, the unfortunate answer to that is no. First of all, we never closed. We remain open. We remain open and available for students who are unable to return home and who need to stay here to complete their studies. The other thing is, of course, as you remember last year, we did have to shut down the campus, and we did offer refunds during that time. But what you may not know is that we actually had to seek special permission from our state board of trustees and the legislature in order to offer those refunds. So generally, this late in the semester, we're just not able to offer refunds to our students.
Thank you so much for that answer. And to follow up with another question, a student asks about the emergency funds that they have been receiving emails about. Can you elaborate more about what the emergency funds are used for and how these students can have access to it?
Well, we have several options in terms of emergency funds. Of course, we have CARES funds, stimulus funds that will be going out starting on March the 1st. And we look forward to providing that to all of our students. In addition, we have other resources such as gear funds that we applied for through a grant. We'll make those funds available, as well as private donations and sources that we have solicited to further help our students. All of that information will be forthcoming, and we look forward to providing that resource for our students.
So, President Hudson, some students were inquiring about guidelines for the professors, especially during the recent inclement weather that we have gotten through. So, could you please elaborate, are there any guidelines or procedures in place for the professors?
Well, we recognize that this has been a very difficult time for our students and certainly can affect their learning outcomes. So we did implement a mandatory 7-day extension for all assignments and projects which may be due. In addition, we did push back the midterms, so the midterms will actually start a week later. Of course, we ask that you work with your professors on any additional modifications. One thing, though, I know the question that has been asked is, well, why haven't we just canceled classes? Why are we still attempting to do virtual classes during this environment with power and water issues? And the simple fact is that we have to be mindful of learning outcomes, things as it relates to examinations, licensures for those who are in professional programs, and also just contact hour requirements that we have to have. Despite what's going on, despite the pandemic, despite the water and power issues, you know, this is still, the learning environment still has to take place. We're going to do all we can to support you during this effort, but that learning has to continue.
Yes, sir. Thank you for that answer. And some students were also wondering if their professor isn't abiding by the 7-day extension guideline, what is their protocol to do to make sure that they can ensure that their academic prowess still remains at a high maintenance?
Well, we encourage you to reach out to us, whether it's through me, through my email, through your professors, department chairs, and just let us know when you're experiencing that or any other problems that you may have in terms of accessing your learning. Again, we understand and we're mindful of everything that the students are going through, and we want to do everything we can to ensure that they continue to seek their education despite what's going on. And we're going to give as much grace and extend as much compassion as we can in order to help you do that.
So some students feel that they are unable to talk with their deans or their professors or even their chairs, and so they believe that they have been met with a level of unprofessionalism with some JSU faculty members and some JSU employees. What is the university doing about employee and faculty member unprofessionalism towards students?
Well, I'm glad you asked that question. Customer service is so important. We hear a lot about it, but it's really relevant, especially in times such as today. Every student deserves to have their issues and concerns addressed. They deserve to have open dialogue with the communication with their faculty, their teachers, their advisors, even the administration, all the way up to myself. So it's certainly on me, and I put myself first in terms of making sure we always communicate with our students and exhibit the proper customer service. I do recognize that there are times when we're going through a crisis situation that you might not get to your email. Even I am overwhelmed with emails oftentimes, but we certainly want to make sure we exhibit that professionalism. One of the things that we're going to do is really enhance and implement customer service training as part of our professional development for all faculty and staff. We've done that in the past, but it's important to get a refresher every now and then to really understand the reasons we're here and to really enforce those principles, and we're committed to doing that.
So, President Hudson, could you please explain the university's stance on students' mental health during this time?
Well, we recognize that these are challenging times for our students and their mental health, and we are thankful to have the Latasha Norman Center available to offer virtual therapy sessions, both in a group and individual setting. In addition, we have partnered with Meta Teletherapy, one of the first entities to actually offer teletherapy counseling for college students. Of course, please contact Student Affairs for further information about these services, but again, we are proud to offer these services as a way to help our students through these challenging times.
Yes, sir. COVID-19 has limited the amount of community service hours that students are supposed to complete per their graduation requirements. Will there be any exceptions made to those who have been affected and not able to have completed their community service hours in order to be cleared for graduation?
Yes, we have waived community service hour requirements through the fall 2021 semester, so this shouldn't be an impediment to anyone graduating this spring.
So speaking of graduation, are there any safety precautions planned for the spring 21 graduation? And will these precautions affect the number of guests that graduates can bring?
Well, of course, you've all received the save the date for May 7th and May 8th for our first in-person commencement in the last year and a half that will be held at Mississippi Memorial Stadium. We're utilizing that venue for both ceremonies in order to take advantage of the open air and also the space, which allows us to social distance. As we speak, the commencement committee is working on protocols to ensure the health and the safety of all participants, including your guests. So be on the lookout for further details, but our goal is to provide a joyous commencement occasion while maintaining the safety of yourself and your family.
Are we expected to have in-person classes in the fall?
We do intend to have in-person classes in the fall. Now, I say that with the caveat that, of course, we will follow all CDC guidelines and we'll follow the conditions at the time. But it is very much our intention, and we are planning to open back up fully this fall, actually starting in the summer with our first summer session. It is important that we get some level of normalcy back. We're looking forward, of course, the vaccine is becoming more prevalent. So it's just very important that we open back up fully this fall.
So in order to get back to a sense of normalcy, students were wondering, will the COVID-19 vaccination be required for both students and faculty members?
Right now it's not required, but it's certainly encouraged. Jackson State is actually going to be a vaccine provider for both our faculty and staff and the community at large. So we look forward to our faculty, our staff, our students at the appropriate time becoming vaccinated. I've been vaccinated, and we've done a lot of work at JSU to really put the right information out there about the vaccine and really how it's going to be a part of the solution as we look to reopen this fall.
So President Hudson, what can the university do to enhance the experience of online students to help them feel more connected and involved in the university and campus life activities?
Well, you know, in many ways, Anaiah, we will be in this virtual learning environment forever. In fact, you know, online was already the wave of the future. The pandemic has just accelerated that. And we're committed to providing a more richer online experience for our students. That starts with professional development for our faculty, our existing faculty, a lot of whom were thrust into this online environment but are now learning new things and learning different techniques to stay connected with the students. But also just overall, you know, that connectivity is really what makes HBCUs great. And we have to strive to really improve that here on campus and really offer you that full campus experience, whether you're an online student or whether you're here in the residence halls. And we certainly welcome any suggestions, any feedback from our students on how we can better do that.
So some students were inquiring about their work study. As you know, that most students have not been able to use their work study because of the pandemic. So the students were asking, will there be a financial penalty from the university since they are not eligible or able to do work study at this moment?
Well, for students who are unable to get their work study hours due to the inclement weather and other factors, we are committed to paying those students. So we will continue their payments as normal. We don't want any student to incur a financial penalty for circumstances that were certainly beyond their control.
So President Hudson, are there any financial resources available for those who are online students?
Yes, of course, we have CARES stimulus funds that are available for both all our students, including online and traditional. So we look forward to distributing those funds starting the week of March the 1st. In addition, we have gear funds, funds that we receive from private donors that will be used to further help these students. And be on the lookout for further information as we distribute those funds throughout the semester.
Yes, sir. Will there be any options of taking online classes in the summer and in the fall semesters of this year?
Yes, the virtual learning environment that we currently experience will always be with us. Of course, we have online classes, we have online programs. Online was the wave of the future, and in many ways, the pandemic has accelerated that. So yes, we will have online classes, virtual classes going forward, but we do look forward to offering a large number of in-person, those traditional classes for our students starting this summer and certainly into the fall.
So thank you so much, President Hudson, for hearing the voices of our students and addressing their concerns. So do you have any final thoughts after tonight's conversation?
Well, I thank you, Anaiah, and I thank you to students for your questions. Just to end, I know this has been a very challenging time for our students. It's been a challenging time for everyone, and it's certainly not how I plan to spend the first few months of my presidency. But I do believe better days are ahead. We will get past this pandemic. We will get past the water crisis. We have a lot to look forward to. Commencement, we have Blue and White Week, and it all leads up to a very promising summer and fall. So again, I thank you so much for your time. I thank you for sticking with us. We will be a stronger JSU after all of this is done.
So we have come to the close of tonight's Q&A. Again, I'd like to thank all of the students for your questions and your attention tonight. And I want to thank President Hudson for patiently addressing our concerns. Please remember to download the JSU Safe app and enable push notifications to be alerted of the latest university updates. Also, please be sure to monitor JSU social media accounts and the JSU website. Thank you again.